Hi, my qualifications for doing this video are I was a committeeman for the Democratic Party, and I did voter registration, and I've worked on many, many campaigns for the Democrats and then the Republicans, and I actually hit a foray with a third party at one point in between, but I didn't like what I seen. Like they had an election and the guy won by 2 votes, and somebody there says he voted abstain and somebody else said they voted abstain, and he counted the people in the room and totaled the numbers up. The numbers didn't come out, he said. Like somebody was cheating. They said zero abstinent, you know, vote. But anyways, that goes on a lot. We have in Rochester recently, we had a primary, and Harry Bronson, the incumbent for state assembly, wanted his attorney, I believe they said it in the paper, his attorney to watch the votes being counted. He didn't trust them. And then the other woman running for another race, a three-way race, the head of the Ibero League, and this may still be in court, says people were getting absentee ballots or whatever from that only had 2 people's name on it and not hers, and she was suing, and I haven't heard what happened. So this is right in the party we've had problems, and I know people that work at the polls, and in the city somebody said a few years back that people were trying to vote twice. Anyways, if you vote by absentee ballot, say that goes to the House, I mean, how do you know the little kid ain't getting it and mailing it in, and then the guy saying he never got it or whatever, or not caring that he got it, or the guy person just don't vote and somebody's mailing that in. If you do it on the computer, the same thing, a little kid or whoever, you know, could vote. And then, you know, you have something verifiable. Somebody in there in person and checked their signature, you have to verify them. You can count those votes over 3 times or whatever. It doesn't matter, because it could be the absentee ballot that the little kid sent in and signed the signature. And unless you verify the signature and verify the person that did the signature, you can't verify it. I believe people think that, well, if my side won, it's okay. The next election could be fixed, maybe by the other guys, because they may see what's going on. Some of the things I've witnessed, and this is one reason I'm no longer a Democrat, they had an open vote for the head of the party. That's name was Brown, and the other guy, I'm trying to think what the other guy's name was, Sakara. So the guys I went to on the committee said, this is how you're going to vote, you know? That's all you need to know. So they said, Sakara. So anyways, it was an open vote, and it was like Brown, Brown, Sakara, Brown, Brown, Sakara, Brown, Brown, Sakara, and it got to this guy whose name was out of me in the alphabet. It was alphabetical order, and the man said, Brown. And afterwards, I said to his son, what happened? He says, well, my father likes to go with a winner, which means these open roll call votes do influence it. And there's another instant when we voted on the committee for who runs for, was it mayor or something? They take and they look at the handwritten ballot. They look at it before they put it in a box. And if you work for City Hall or get a contract or whatever, you're going to be in trouble if you don't vote right. And then there was a story from Jimmy Carter in Georgia. The election, the guy that handled the welfare would take your ballot and he would look at it and then he would put it in the box. And again, he would disqualify it from welfare. And back then, I think it was democratically controlled. I think Georgia's more gone more Republican since then. It was a solid South, you know, Democrat years ago. But you know, they cheated. They even had dead people, Carter said, voting, because the widow could vote for her dead husband so many years after or whatever. I mean, what's that, you know? You have gerrymandering where the candidates pick the voters. You know, so they the vote is fixed before you even go in there. It might be 2-to-1 ratio, one party versus the other. So even before you even go in there, the vote is fixed. That should be illegal. And then you have the elections commissioners are from the parties. And I've been up there and I noticed you had actually candidates, politicians working there, people that were elected, if you can believe that, and there were committee people in there. And I just think that, and there was party officials and stuff working in there. Now, how can you have that, you know? And I don't want to mention names, but it just seems like if I was running a primary against them, they're running the Board of Elections down there. Don't you think it's biased, if you know what I mean? And what about third parties? They have no say. It's Republican, Democrat commissioners. What about Green Party, Conservative Party, Working People's Party? They have no say in this, you know? So they can't even fix it, is the joke. But like I say, if you don't think stuff's being fixed, I think you got serious problems, because I was an insider and I've seen this. For instance, I went to numerous credit union meetings. And the one credit union, they didn't give notification to everybody. Anyways, I got there. That's another story. I just happened to find out about it. And I went to the meeting, and they said, all the employees stand up, the board stand up, this stand up. And I was, me and another guy were the only people that were members of the credit union and didn't work there or on the board or whatever. And they had the election, and nobody was running against them. They said they were elected. There was no candidates to run against them. But if you look at it, you had to have, say, 500 signatures in their bank account numbers, too. Now, who would sign that? Who would sign your bank account number to something, to especially a stranger? And so they probably never had an election. They appointed the first people when they started the credit union, and they probably never had, and this is two different ones, I was the only guy there, just about, that I could see, that wasn't an employee or whatever. They probably never had an election, because there was nobody challenging them. So again, election's fixed, and for them to get up there and say the duly elected person after this, you know, there was no election. Another observation, voting for the head of the Democratic Party, they had proxies was one of the issues. You know, one guy walked in with 25 proxies, you know, from people that never went to the meetings, whatever. And you don't know if they're verified. I mean, you know, whatever. So that was a big issue. So I went to the vote. I got there at 5 o'clock. It started at 6, supposedly. And I got there at 5 o'clock, and they said the vote was over. I said, why is the vote over? It's supposed to start at 6. They said, well, what's his name, walked in with enough proxies to win the election before it even started. And his platform was he wanted to eliminate proxies. And he won by proxies before the vote even happened. I mean, think about that. And they settled it so each one person could carry one proxy. But this is how I believe votes are fixed. I mean, I've seen this stuff. You know, I just hold my hands up. The election's over before I even got there. And I think both parties do it, maybe one more than any other. And I think if people don't take this seriously, you're going to lose your democracy. And they're all, you know, trying to blame their party and the other guy. And you got to have stuff that's verifiable. And you got to understand that elections can be fixed. And even if they say there's no evidence, there probably isn't any evidence, because you can't verify the signatures. And it might be not widespread, but only maybe 1%, but the person might have won by 0.5%. So a lot of these words, not widespread, no evidence, don't mean as much as you think. Because I've worked on many campaigns, I've seen many elections, and heard many things from both parties behind the scenes. This is not the first time there's been accusations of a vote being fixed. That's happened with the dangling chads, with Al Gore, Kennedy versus Nixon. They said there was more votes in Chicago than people registered. There was many times this has happened. But we've got to pay attention to this, because I think we're going to lose it. I really think democracy is on its way out. electronic voting machines can be hacked, and there's many people, and it's probably more liberal than conservative, will tell you this because they're computer programmers. It can be hacked or changed or made for a certain time. Boom, something happens at a certain time, a little bug will flip the vote. I don't believe in this electronic thing. You need a paper ballot, something that can be verified. So these new modern things don't work any better than the old voting machine or something that has a paper ballot. You know, don't go for this. Plus, if something's on the internet, they can change it from a remote location. And if they standardize all this stuff, it's easier to fix all over the country, because now it's such a mess, it's a little harder to fix. So look at it that way.